गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 3 टिने एंड द फार अवे माउंटेन. ओके, सो द थर्ड चैप्टर इज टिने एंड द फार अवे माउंटेन. इन इकैली इन द मिशमी हिल्स ऑफ अरुणाचल प्रदेश यंग टिने मिने heard a wondrous call from the mountains in the distance. She was drawn to it, a sound only she could hear. Now there is a Mishmi hills in Ikali, okay, and there was a young girl named Tine Mine heard a wondrous call. Wondrous means wondrous call. Wondrous means wonderful, or you can say almost magical. Okay, so she heard a magical call from the mountains in the distance. She was drawn to it, a sound only she could hear. So after listening that sound, she was very interested in it, and that sound was heard by her only. Okay, she heard it while she climbed trees. She heard it when she ran through the jungle. She heard it when she spent long days lying under the sun. Hushu, the sound went hushu. Okay, so when she used to hear these sounds while climbing trees, while running through the jungle, okay, and when she spent long days lying under the sun, Tine would smile. What a wonderful life. But one day, her family moved out of Ikali to the closest big town, Roing. Now one day what happened? Her family moved out of Ikali to the closest big town, Roing. Tine's world turned upside down. Tine's world turned upside down means her life changed completely and she was upset because she used to enjoy in that jungle. There was a school in Roing, but the hushu had been louder in Ikali. But this sound was quite louder in Ikali. Tine wanted to return to her mountains again. She wanted to return to her mountains again. So she trudged to school every day for 10 years, glancing wistfully at the mountains in the horizon. When she finally finished her schooling, Tine immediately applied to be a porter for army expeditions in the mountains. She would have to carry heavy loads and march over long distances. So Tine wanted to return to her mountains again. So she trudged to school every day. Trudged means walked with slow and heavy steps, because she did not want to do something. Okay, for 10 years really she did not like that place, so she wanted to move back to the mountains again. For 10 years glancing wistfully. Wistfully means with great longing at the mountains in the horizon, because she used to pass her day in the mountains. When she finally finished her schooling, Tine immediately applied to be a porter for army expeditions. Porter means a person who carries luggage and other heavy loads. Expeditions, journeys by a group of people, usually for a particular purpose, such as Edmund Hillary's expeditions to reach the top of Mount Everest. Okay, so she applied to be a porter for army expeditions. Okay, and she would have to carry heavy loads and march over long distances. But women were not allowed to be porters in those days. But in those days, women were not allowed to be porters. Tine did not let that stop her. She dressed as a boy and started to work. Now what she did? She dressed as a boy and started to work. carrying nearly 25 kilos of luggage every day. She used to carry 25 kilos of luggage every day. A whole week passed before everyone realized that she was a girl disguised as a boy. Now after a week everybody realized that she was a girl and disguised as a boy. Now come to next page. The office scolded Tine for breaking the rules. Now when they come to know that Tine is a girl, not a boy, then officers scolded her, okay? But they knew that Tine knew the route better than anyone else. But they also knew that the Tine knows the route better than anyone else. So they allowed her to continue working. Her act would later help lift the ban on female porters. Now due to her act only, the ban on female porters were lifted. Okay, lifted ban means a law that does not allow people to do something. In the army, Tine worked on many expeditions and soon became a coordinator. Now what happened in the army? Tine worked on many expeditions, okay, and soon became a coordinator. Coordinator means someone who plans trips to the mountains. It was one of her expeditions as a coordinator that she met Dr. Romeo Maiti. At that time, Dr. Maiti was working to promote adventure sports in Arunachal Pradesh. Adventure sports meaning exciting sports like mountaineering, whitewater rafting and so on, and immediately identified Tine's talent. Then Dr. Maiti immediately identified Tine's talent. "You are a natural gifted climber," he told her. Then Dr. Romeo Maiti told Tine that "you are a naturally gifted climber." Naturally gifted means someone who does something very well on their own. Okay, someone who does very well in their own is known as naturally gifted. "You have the strength and the determination." He also said to her that you have the strength and the determination. Now all you need is technique. So determination meaning a strong desire to do something, but she only needs technique. Dr. Maiti became Tine's mentor and she began her training as a mountain climber. The distant mountains still called her. Now what happened? Dr. Maiti became Tine's mentor. Mentor means a person who helps, teaches and advises someone regularly. But Tine did not know the name of the distant mountains till she was the race for Everest. So Tine did not know the name of the distant mountains till she was the race of Everest. A film about the first climb of Mountain Everest. Fushu became a roar now, and climbing Mount Everest became her dream. Now climbing Mount Everest became her dream. After months of preparations, Tine finally reached the Everest base camp in Nepal. Base camp means a safe camp area, usually at the foot of mountain. People start climbing the mountain from this point. From base camp, people start climbing the mountain. It is a safe area. It was bitterly cold and the air was thin. it was very cold there and the air was thin. Air was thin means there wasn't enough air to breathe properly. Okay, Tine trained there for a few days to get accustomed to the harsh weather and then began her climb. Now Tine was trained there for few days to get accustomed meaning used to, okay, to the harsh climate or harsh weather, and then began her climb. The climb was difficult. Okay, now let us see Tine's climbing in next page. It was divided into four sections so that the climbers could take rest at different camping points. Now it was divided into four sections so that climbers could take rest at different camping points while journeying to the top of mountain. But the time Tine and her companion Sherwin Sherpa reached the second camp, the weather had grown worse. Now when Tine and her companion Sherwin Sherpa reached the second camp, the weather had gone worse. Do you want to go ahead? Sherwin asked to her, do you want to go ahead? I don't think I will get another chance to do this. Then Tine replied that I don't think I will get another chance to do this. She could hear the musical wushu growing louder and louder. It almost hypnotized her. Hypnotized meaning affected her like a magical spell. Okay. Tine and Sherwin somehow managed to reach their final camp. Now somehow they reached their final camp. Just as they were about to take rest, the stormy wind blew their tent and supplies away. Supplies means things like food, torches, first aid kit and so on. So what happened? The stormy wind blew their tent as well as supplies. Okay. They had to spend the night in one borrowed tent, and when they set off for the final climb the next day, all Tine and Sherwin had was a packet of noodles. Only they had a packet of noodles. Let's share half of it, Sherwin suggested. So Sherwin suggested that let's share half of it. Tine nodded her head, smiling determinedly. If we make it alive, we will eat the other half. Then Tine said that if we make it alive, we will eat the other half. Make it alive means manage to finish the climb and return alive. Then we will eat the other half. The higher they climbed, the stronger the wind grew. The higher they climbed, the stronger the wind grew. For every two steps they took, it sent them reeling back a step. Now what was happening? For every two steps they took, it sent them reeling back a step. Reeling back means moving backwards very unsteadily, or you can say very fast. They were moving back very fast. It shrieked and howled, whispering dread into their ears and urging them to return. Now what happened? Due to this, they were thinking, not thinking means they were definitely had a great fear and uncertainty about what could happen. They were in the great fear and they were uncertain that what could happen. Urging means trying to persuade or make someone do something, them to return. But Tine could only hear the magical tune of Wushu. Means they were in so much trouble that sometimes they thought to return. Okay. But the magical tune of Wushu was calling Tine, and Tine could only hear the magical tune of Wushu. So they pushed ahead fearlessly and continued to climb to the top. Finally, at 10:45 a.m. on 9th May 2011, Tine's efforts were rewarded. She submitted Mount Everest. Submitted means climbed to the top of a mountain. She submitted Mount Everest, the highest mountain in the world. The first woman from the northeast of India to have done so. She had found her faraway mountain and was one with the sound that had called her all her life. So this is the story of Tine and faraway mountain, that how she summited the Mount Everest. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.